everybody's talking about when are we going to get a little break.
Yeah, the heat has been pretty oppressive, especially going into late August, and a lot of folks think about fall, not too far away. And giving a little taste here tonight, I want to show you the difference in temperatures just in the last 24 hours. We've taken about a 9-degree drop here in Dayton. You can see the cooler air back to the north and west, where it is almost 20 degrees colder. In South Bend, about 11-degree drop in Kalamazoo. That cooler air headed this way. It's not going to stick around very long, but we'll enjoy the break. Outside right now, we've got clouds. Showers have pushed away. There's very little breeze there on the flag in Xenia, 72 degrees. Winds have switched direction out of the north to northwest at 6. We had no rainfall, at least officially at the airport in Dayton. Some of you saw a lot, some of you, nothing at all. That's kind of the way it worked today. 64 in Urbana, 64 expected in the morning in Springfield, 66 in Springboro. Showers and thunderstorms have moved away, so we're going to look for clouds to linger, but it should be dry for the kids at the bus stop in the morning. There's a chance for a quick shower, though, tomorrow afternoon. We'll get up to about 78 as the kids head home from school. I want to show you live Doppler 7 radar right now, and it is quiet, at least here close by. Showers and thunderstorms have moved well off to the south and east of us. You can see them pushing through West Virginia, over into Pennsylvania. If you were out earlier tonight, you probably saw a lot of lightning in the southern skies. Those storms were moving away. We did not get a whole lot of rain across the valley. A cold front came through pretty quickly, and now we'll turn our attention to the drop in humidity over the next couple of days. Take a look at this. Futurecast showing that that humidity drop will gradually push in tonight and tomorrow. Now, there could be some fog tonight, as it may take some time for the humidity to scour out. It never really completely gets out of the area, but at least it does get a bit more comfortable tomorrow and Friday before the humidity comes back, just in time for the holiday weekend. Here is Futurecast. I want to show you hour by hour through the night and into 7 o'clock in the morning. Notice the showers are gone, at least for the night, but the clouds never really leave. And we could see some regeneration of light showers as we get into the afternoon tomorrow. And this is going to be mainly because some cool air comes in aloft. That front never gets a good push southward, so it hangs out close by. And with that overriding moisture, there could be a quick shower as we head into the afternoon hour. So don't be surprised if that happens. It won't be enough, really, to help your garden or your lawn, but there could be some sprinkles. Temperatures tomorrow will top out in the 70s as opposed to the 80s and 90s. We'll get back to 77 in Sydney, 81 expected in Springfield, 81 Xenia, about 80 in Oxford, 75, though, in Salina. Here's our forecast hour by hour. If you're just cast through the daytime tomorrow, 68 in the morning. Notice the clouds hang out with that chance for a few passing showers. A light rain, though, 2 to about 5 o'clock, and not everyone will see a shower, but there's that chance. I want to show you what we're watching for the weekend real quick as you make your plans for Saturday. Front kind of backs up into the area, so we'll see that increase in humidity for us Friday night into Saturday. And there is a chance as we get into Saturday afternoon that there could be enough moisture for some pop-up showers and thunder showers. Not a washout this weekend, but we may have to duck inside for an hour or two as some of that rain passes by. That could happen Saturday and happen into Sunday as well. I want to show you the extended forecast here. It is looking like we'll see at least a passing shower, a thunder shower, as we head into the weekend. For some reason, it skipped past my five-day forecast. Let's see if we can get it to pop back up here. The threat for showers and thunder showers at least a little more numerous as we get into Sunday. We do climb back into the middle 80s for highs. Then notice as we head into Monday and Tuesday, we may be back to 90. So even though Labor Day is coming, summer is not coming to an end. In the morning, we will keep you posted. Brett Collar in for Kirstie at the latest at 425.
And tomorrow morning, at Troy, a historical marker will be unveiled. The marker tells the story of lock number 12 of the Miami and East Canal. The marker is at the entrance to Treasure Island. The lock was uncovered in the basement of the Hobart Brothers Company when crews demolished a factory building in 2015.
The state of Ohio.